For these kind of resources, for example, the population of a given species, the grow level hence is a function of the stock level itself. And typically, the grow initially is exponential, but then it starts to slow down due to limiting factors, and finally, asymptotically reached a maximum level of stock. This level of stock can be constant, or more realistically, a level over which there is some oscillations, but we will consider in our model a constant level of maximum stock. Also, another things we are not going to consider is the fact that often there is at the opposite a minimum level, a minimum threshold of stocks, typically when organism with sexual reproductions. And in this case, if the stocks is below this minimum level of stock, the grow is negative and finally lead to the extinction of that population. So if we chart this curve over time, we have a stock level that initially grow very fast to then asymptotically reaching this S-max level. This function that regulate the dynamic of this kind of resource, and in particular of biological populations, take the name of logistic function or Warhol's model. And this is the question that describe this sigmoid, and where A, B, and C are parameter of the specific populations, and in particular, we can notice that when the three parameters are positive, if we take the limit for t equal to the infinite, this factor go to zero, and hence the stock is at t equal infinite is equal to b. So the parameter b is the level at which the stock can asymptotically arrive. And if we derive with respect to time, so we rewrote the equation in these terms, and we take the derivative with respect to time to both sides. So we here with a dot, I mean the derivative of the stock. Here we apply the chain rules, and we notice that we isolate here again the stock, so we can rewrite this equation in these terms. Then we can reuse the equations to isolate this factor. We can replace this factor here with this one, and we can finally rewrite our equations of the variation of the stock as a functions of the stock themselves, so is a quadratic function of the level of the stock. And if there are no human interferences, the variation of the stock of the resource is equal to its grow functions, and is given by this equation. So the sigmoid function as the stock as a function of t take the name of logistic function. When we instead we represent as the grow or variation of the stock as a function of the stock itself, it take the name of biological regeneration functions. And be aware that this is the instantaneous grow, not the grow rate. The grow rate, when you hear about grow rate, you have the variation of the stock over the stock itself. And it is something that is the grow rate start always to infinite and gradually decrease in this form. Well, actually, it goes to zero here. This one doesn't go. The biological regeneration functions is hence a differential equation where the resource grow depend from its own stock. And this is why we call renewable stock resources, because they exhibit a density dependence grow. And in the space grow stock, it draw as a concave parabola where the maximum is reached at the stock level equal to B over 2, and the maximum itself, that is known as maximum sustainable yield, is equal to AB over 4. And we can find these two values by simple finding the first order conditions for the grow functions, and we obtain them.